You've seen my videos where I buy coin grab bags off eBay and get absolutely scammed. Well, this week I'm flipping the script and showing you what it looks like when I prepare a coin grab bag for a customer and how it can be both profitable for me as the seller and also totally fair and worthwhile for the customer. You can have the best of both worlds with coin grab bags. And be sure to stay tuned till the end of the video to see who won last week's contest for this 1 ounce Atmex bar and how you can win this week's contest for this 1 ounce 999 pure silver Queen's Beast coin. Hello everybody, Silver Picker here, and welcome to the Silver Picker Squad. Now, today's video is a little bit of a role reversal for me because normally I'm on the receiving end of eBay coin grab bags, not on the selling end. But a few weeks ago, a viewer just like you emailed me and said, I've been watching your videos and I see that all the coin grab bags are scams. I don't know what to do because I still want one. Can you, Silver Picker, make me a grab bag that's fair? And I said, why didn't I think of that? Absolutely, I'm up for the challenge. Now, the critical thing is that I made sure to understand what he actually wanted so that I could make sure that I satisfied him as a customer. So I said, first off, what's your budget and what do you collect? He said that he's looking to spend $100 and he collects coins from all over the world, but mostly likes to focus on US coins. And he said that he is actually rebuilding his collection that was recently lost. Now, I don't know if it was stolen, I don't know if he had to sell it out of need, but either way, he doesn't have his collection anymore and wants to start it from scratch. So now that I have that information, I can customize a grab bag that fits his collecting needs and his budget. Now, before we get started and look into the actual stuff that I'm sending him, I want to point out that a lot of people comment on my grab bag videos when I clearly have been scammed, that they say, how could you expect $100 worth of stuff in a $100 grab bag? The seller needs to make a profit. Well, the truth is that's not how the business works. The business works on the buy side. You make your money as a seller on the buy side. What I do is I buy large collections in bulk, meaning the people that I'm buying from, it saves them time, energy, they don't have to go out and sell each coin piecemeal. So I buy the whole collection at a discount, and let's say I buy it at a 30% discount, then when I sell it for its full value, meaning the fair market value, I make my 30% return. So that way, I'm able to sell somebody $100 worth of goods for $100 and still make a profit. And that's what you gotta focus on and see how the scammers on eBay are double dipping. They're buying for cheap because that's how it is in the industry, but they're also selling it to you for less than the value and you are getting ripped off. So with that, let's get right into it and take a look at what I provided him in this $100 grab bag. All right, so let's get started. So there's a lot of stuff that I have in here that if you've been watching my channel for a while, you will recognize as stuff that I've purchased in the past. Now, this is a really good time to mention that if you're interested in getting into the business of buying and selling coins, but you're also a collector like me, the great thing about it is you can buy a collection from people and then you basically pick out what you want and then sell the rest. It's that simple, and that's what I do. So some of these things that you've noticed I've bought in the past or I've gotten from other grab bags are things that don't fit into my personal collection, but I can flip them for a profit. Now, what you'll see here is that I'm going to be making a grab bag with things that I don't necessarily want, but are of real value, they're not junk, and I'm gonna be giving them for sure, the value of what they purchased. So anyway, the first thing is this 2011 United States Mint uncirculated set. This is the Philadelphia half. And I think it's a really, really nice thing, especially for this guy who said that he lost his entire collection and wants a variety of coins. So this is a really, really nice set of coins from the modern era. Next up, we've got something a little bit older. This is the US nickel collection. You know, it's in a nice little designed holder and everything, but don't pay too much attention to that. Basically, what we're really after here is the war nickel, the V nickel, and the Buffalo nickel. These three are not really worth anything, but it's a cool little thing to have. And again, if you're trying to rebuild a collection, it's kind of a cool way to get all the different nickels through the years. So that's pretty cool. Speaking of nickels, this is actually a really nice one. This is a 1987S proof nickel. It's in great shape. It's not worth $350, but it is a really, really nice nickel. And for anybody that wants to get proofs, nickels are a really good way to start because they are inexpensive. Next up, still going with the large flat item theme. This you may have noticed from another
video. This is the No Motto collection, and it has a bunch of different coins that have no motto, meaning in God we trust. So we've got an Indian head cent, we've got a Liberty V nickel, a Buffalo nickel, and a Barber dime. Now this over here is a $1 silver certificate. I actually replaced the $2 Red Seal note that was in here because I did want that for my collection. So this is a really good way where you can sort of pick what you want from your own purchases for your own collection and then sell the stuff that you have doubles of. I've got many, many silver certificates. So it's a cool way to sort of pass it along and also get what you want out of it. So that's pretty cool. I'm also including another $1 silver certificate. I can't get enough of these. I love them. I have so many of them, and it's always a nice little treat to add into the collection. All right, moving on to some more American coins. The guy did say that he wanted mostly American coins, so that is what I'm giving him. This is really cool. It's a little tough to see because of the lighting. I'm sorry, I don't have great lighting today, but this is an 1863 Indian head cent, and you can't really see it through the 2x2, but these are from one of the early years of the Indian head cent, and it was before they made them out of the same material that they make them out of throughout the rest of the series. So this is actually a significantly thicker bronze coin, and it is worth quite a bit more than the average Indian head cent. Really, really cool. I have one of these in my own type set, of course. So that's a really, really good type coin. Now you gotta get some really nice junk silver, of course. You know, we don't want any of this, nonsense where there's one little piece of silver in a grab bag. See, that's what these scammers on eBay do. They say, oh, you're gonna get one coin before 1950, whatever it is, right? And then they give you a piece of junk, right? They say, we're gonna give you one American silver coin, and it's a war nickel, right? I did include war nickels in here, but not just war nickels. So I made sure to have some really nice junk silver, not just Roosevelt dimes either. These are all early date Mercs. These are all early date. So like, what do we got here? We've got 1919, got 1916, and there's 13 of them. So that's pretty good. That's really, really nice, right? Next up, still on the silver train. This is really cool. I got a bunch of these from a previous grab bag, and it's not worth a ton, but it's Russian wire money. These are from like the 1500s. And they've got some Cyrillic writing on the back. They're silver. They are really, really cool. And for somebody that's trying to rebuild a collection, even though he mostly said he wants American stuff, he did say he's open to some foreign. And I think this is a really, really cool piece of silver to add to your collection. And it's a really, really old coin. All right, next up. Again, I'm going in no particular order. It's just kind of like, it's really a reverse grab bag. Here we've got a bunch of nickels. We have a war nickel. We have two Buffalo nickels, one with no date, one with a date, and three Buffalo nickels, and two with dates, one with no date, and of course, two more Liberty V nickels. I love the V nickels. Used to be my favorite coin, my favorite American coin. I've since changed what my favorite coin is, and I go back and forth, but right now I'm really, really into the trade dollars. I think that's my favorite coin now. All right, so we've got a couple of nickels. And this is just something I threw in for fun because I don't collect tokens or casino tokens, casino chips, whatever it is. This is a Foxwoods casino token from 1992. It's not worth very much, but, you know, it's a cool little thing, and it's kind of just a way to say, hey, this is a casino token. Maybe it's something you'd be interested in collecting. So here is an example. Same with this. This is really just, again, a novelty piece, but it's cool. And because I don't know what he's looking for, because it is a grab bag, I want to expose him to as much as I can while still giving him value. So this is a Lewis and Clark gold-plated nickel. It's not worth a buck, but it's still pretty cool. Right? Again, grab bags are all about introducing people to coins that they wouldn't have otherwise purchased. But again, the key point is would be happy to receive, right? So I want this guy to be really happy that he received it. I want him to feel that he got the value. And for all of you guys in the comments section, most of you guys get it. I know most of you guys who've been watching my videos get it, but some of you constantly will comment on my grab bag videos saying, what did you expect? If you pay $100, how can they make any money if they give you $100 worth of stuff? Well, that's because you buy smart. I buy these coins in big lots at a discount so I can still make a profit while giving the buyer what they deserve. If they're paying for $100 worth of coins, they should get $100 worth of coins. This is really cool. These are antique sales tax tokens from the state of Missouri. We've got one of these smaller red ones, as well as one of these bigger gray ones with the outline of the state of Missouri. That's pretty cool. And another piece of silver. We've got an 1898 barber dime. It's not in great shape, but still, it's a barber dime, and it is in a nice date, of course. Ah, this is cool. This you've seen in my Russia grab bag video. I kept a bunch of those coins from the Russia grab bag video, but I thought this was cool because he said that he's not looking for a ton of foreign stuff, like I said, but if he does want something, this is cool because it covers a lot of bases. It covers commemorative, because this is a World Cup commemorative. It covers coins and banknotes. It also has a really nice little display thing, and it's a cool thing that if he decides he wants to display his coins on a shelf, this is a really cool thing because it's colorful, it looks nice, and it's worth about 10 bucks. It sells for even more sometimes, which is really great, of course. Speaking of foreign banknotes, I'm including a bunch of these foreign banknotes. Again, I'm pricing this really low, so, you know, it's not like he's paying a ton for this, because he said that he's not so into it, but I still want to expose him to it, and it is something that is important to have in any collection, just to have examples of, to learn. So I'm giving him a bunch of these foreign banknotes from various time periods. And speaking of banknotes, I am including, of course, one Utah goldback. Now, he can already go on the upma.org website and get himself a free goldback. These are worth about $3. They sell on AppMex for $3 a piece. But that's another PSA. If you go on upma.org, anybody can get a free one. But this will be a second one, so he can get one for himself for free. And then if he wants, he can give one of these away to a friend or relative, or just hold on to it as a second one. Giving him two more raw Indian head cents. These, of course, are later date ones as opposed to the one in the 2x2. These ones are from 1902 and 1905. And these are the standard ones. They're made out of copper, and these are the same size and thickness as the wheat cents and Lincoln cents after that, memorial cents, I should say, but also a critical piece of any collection. And we've got some more silver coming up here. This is a 1951S, which is a semi-key date. You know, it depends on who you're asking, of course, and this is not in amazing shape, but it is worth a little bit over spot, which is nice, and having some better date stuff in your collection is always great. This is just a piece of junk silver. It's not in great shape at all. In fact, it's in pretty crummy shape, but it is a 1964D silver quarter, and it's always nice to have a little bit of junk silver. More junk silver in nicer shape. This is a 1968 quarter from Canada. I actually love the Canadian quarter design. I don't know if I've talked about that in previous videos, but I love coins with animals on them. I think that that's really, really just a great design element for any coin. And it's cool that this one has a moose. Really like it. This is actually a coin I won in a contest on cointalk.com years and years ago. I got a few of them. This is a DDR number 010 for the Minnesota State Quarter, and I got he sent me a couple of them, so I figured I'd include it. You know, I'm including it basically at face value just because I think that it is cool, and he may be into varieties, so why not give him one? Giving him one of these, which is a 1974 S Ike proof. This one is not silver, but it is still a really, really nice proof coin and would go in any type set. I tried to include some things that will fit really nicely in a type set, of course, because that's what I'm really into. And even if he's not into it, it's still a nice coin. And the piece de resistance, what you've all been waiting for, I would say the most valuable coin for sure in this lot, as well as something that is not necessarily what you would find in most grab bags, and I wanted to really have something that would make a splash, and that is a 2012 Australian Koala 1 ounce bullion round. These are 1 ounce bullion coins, and they're from Australia, and they are gorgeous, they are collectible, sought after, they sell for way above spot, and this is a 2012, which I think has a gorgeous, gorgeous design. Look at that frosty background with a beautiful koala in the foreground, Australian koala. You can see over here, it says 2012, 1 ounce, 999, fine silver. And of course, it's got the Australian obverse, as usual, with a $1 face value. So, there you have it. This is what a grab bag should look like. The guy paid $100. It is well over $100. It's 10% above $100, making sure that no matter, even if you think some of my prices, my evaluations were high, which I don't think they were, I tried to be as conservative as possible, looking at eBay sold listings, looking at just knowing what the prices are in the industry. This is what a $100 grab bag should look like, meaning you get $100 worth of value. There's no filler or junk. There's interesting pieces, even things that are not worth much, like these antique Missouri sales tax tokens. These are novel. These are things that you don't necessarily see in a collection every day. Even the Foxwoods token, I'm putting this in almost as a freebie, but things that are unusual or interesting that will be of value to a collector even if they're not worth a ton.
So I hope this video has shown you that you absolutely can get a fair grab bag as long as you know where to look. Going on eBay and just buying one of the random grab bags is probably not a good way to spend your money. Do some research, ask around, and find the good local coin stores or the good sellers that are honest and fair and will give you your money's worth. You don't want to throw away your hard-earned money on garbage on eBay coin grab bags. And now the moment you've all been waiting for. Who won last week's contest to win a 1-ounce Atmex silver bar? Now, before we announce the winner, I just want to tell all of you who are watching for the first time that I decided that this year I'm giving away 52 ounces of silver to viewers like you. That's right, 1 ounce of pure silver every single week, free of charge, just as my way of giving back to the silver stacking and coin collecting community here on YouTube. So, every week, I'm going to have a little task that will help both grow my channel and also reward you guys and enter you into that week's giveaway. So last week, we had a giveaway for a 1-ounce bar from Atmex, and that bar is going to go to somebody that followed me on Instagram. So anyone who's following me on Instagram is entered for the contest. So what we're going to do is we're going to go over here and we're going to log on to Instagram. We're going to pick a random number using the random number generator and count down all the different Instagram followers and see who the winner is. All right, so let's see over here. We've got our Instagram followers and we're going to go to the random number generator. And the random number we have generated between 1 and 1,513, which is my Instagram follower count, is 248. All right, here we are on Instagram. You see that I have 1,513 followers. That's pretty wild because that's up almost 600. So let's start counting. I'm going to fast forward through most of this because you don't want to see me sit here and count to 248. And the winner is Dave underscore R001. Congratulations, Dave. You are the winner of this 1-ounce Atmex bar. I'm going to DM you and send you the congratulations personally and ask you for your address. Send it to me and I will get this coin out to you free of charge. Congrats, man. All right, we're finally on to this week's contest. How can you win this 1-ounce Queen's Beast silver coin from England? Well, it's as simple as it can be. All you need to do is hit me up in the comments down below with your favorite silver coin. That's right, I want to start a conversation around silver stacking and silver coin collecting, and the best way to start that is for you guys to tell me and each other what your favorite silver coin is. So drop a comment, leave your favorite silver coin, and you will be entered. However, there's a little catch. This video needs to have 2,000 likes in order for this contest to count. So the contest won't end until there are 2,000 likes on this video. Very simple, because in the first video I asked for 1,000 and got 3,000. So I'm confident that asking for 2,000 is not too much. So hit me up in the comments below with your favorite coin, leave a like, and of course, like every YouTube giveaway, you gotta be subscribed. So if you're not subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Join us in the Silver Picker Squad, where we learn about coins, about silver, about precious metals, gold, picking, thrifting, and even personal finance, just ways to make a little bit of extra money on your own terms. So I hope you come back next week and watch our next video, because it's gonna be awesome. So we've got a lot more cool stuff coming down the pike, so stay tuned, and until next time, Silver Picker out.